there any information about the Climatics Conference Series in Europe, JAM? Thank you all so much for making sure to do the rest. We have some continuing introductory opening remarks from Dr. Kavai Chandan, who is the Vice Chancellor of Research at the University.
It is the largest city in the country with more than 2 million proximity to the European Union. And here you have the China Watch, which was built up in the last century, taking more of the China Watch from Paris. And this is the Hanoi, the main Hanoi near the Hilton Hotel, which is very famous. And here we have a very important event, which is a musical event, classic music, which is the Georgia Jazz Movement, which was our main proposal for the festival. And here is the most stupid building in Bucharest. I have to admit this. I don't like it at all, but it's very famous. It was built by Georgescu, who was his main dream, having the biggest building in the world. He almost managed to deploy the third building in the world after another stupid building somewhere in North Korea and Chicago. And this is the Royal Palace. Royal Palace is just opposite to the Athenaeum. It was built in 1957 on the place of the old Romanian house. It is U-shaped with two entrances, one on the left by the royal family, the palace, and another one on the right for the officials. We still have events there. It is the main national museum, which is very interesting, and if you have time, you might be able to visit it. And we still have a lot of meetings organized in different parts of the palace. We have one international, one very famous, where a couple of Nobel Prize persons came in order to give lectures. Many of them. And I will introduce you some important people from Romania, Romanian origin. He is our national sculptor, Constantin Dărduș, very famous. He used to work and live in Paris, in France, but he is not Romanian origin. He was born in Romania. Behind me is our national poet, George Enescu, which I mentioned, with the festival, our national composer. Stefan Lucian, our national painter, together with Grigorescu, and Nadia Comăneci, which I'm sure you know very well. She managed to get the first 10 in the Morgan Olympic Games long time ago. And she is still very successful in terms of sport, organizing sport and promoting sport all over the world. This building is the University of Medicine and Pharmacy. It was founded in 1857 by a French Romanian general, medical general, Carlo Dalima, on the left, on the left here, and Nicolae Petrulescu. They built up, they introduced medicine teaching in Romanian medicine education, and they did a lot of good jobs for the medicine in Romania. In fact, what this building was projected and the main architect was Carlo Dalima. We have some very famous medical researchers, most of them graduating from this university, Victor Pavlovich. The first textbook on bacteriology in the world and discovery of the antirabies treatment, which he used all over the world. Nicolae Paulescu, who in fact was the one who discovered insulin, unfortunately he published his discovery in another small journal, and he know better this example. Then it was accepted by the medical community that in fact he is the one who discovered the first insulin. We have a very nice museum dedicated to Nicolae Paulescu near the main library, and Mr. Nemanira can show the museum to you if you are interested. It's a very small one, but it's nice with some books and some portraits and different other things donated by the Paulescu family. Constantin Bachmann, even with endocrinology, then he moved to Yash. But the University of Yash had a fancy name to go at the Korean University. He discovered that he got a lot of people from Heidegger, the auto system, which is still very actual and used in anatomy. And probably the most important one, we are here in the lecture theater, the church in the parliament, was the founder of the cellular biology of the watch, and he managed to receive the Nobel Prize of Medicine in 1974. He graduated here, he was part of our academic staff for a while, and then he emigrated to the United States. He worked in the United States, he produced most of his research in the United States, and eventually he managed to get the Nobel Prize. If I think about Romanian Nobel laureates, we have five, Georgian Nibala, which I already mentioned. Elie Wiesel is of Romanian origin, Romanian and Jewish origin. He emigrated a long time ago to the United States of America and received the Nobel Prize for Peace in 1986. Hertha Müller from Transylvania, of German origin, received the Nobel Prize for Literature in 2009, also of Romanian origin. More recently, 2 years ago, in chemistry, Stefan Walter-Pell, who is also a member of our Academy of Medical Sciences, also of Romanian origin, also from Transylvania. And Ioan Moaru, which is quite often forgotten, unfortunately, he was the co-president of International Physicians for the Prevention of the Nuclear War during the communist era. And together with this organization, he received the Nobel Prize for Peace in 1985. Plus, Georges was not very happy because he was expected to receive the Nobel Prize for Peace. So, unfortunately, this guy was a very good professor, a very nice person, and an excellent researcher. I met him personally when I was a student. He was my teacher in pathology in Victor Babesh Institute. Was not mentioned, but the Nobel Prize recipient, unfortunately, for many, many years. So he is usually forgotten to be mentioned as one of the Romanians probably getting the Nobel Prize, part of the big organization of International Physicians for the Prevention of Nuclear War. How about university today? And these are interesting data we are providing every year in order to show them to our international guests as we are here. 1,760 academic staff, professors, associate professors, senior lecturers, and lecturers and tutors. Almost 10,000 students in total, of which 8,000 are Romanian students, but we have quite a large community of 1,700 foreign students from different classes of culture. And most of them are studying in English. 1,500 PhD students for almost 200 PhD supervisors. And every year we are trying to keep this number of at least 1,000 full-text papers published in journals of any part, and we try to increase it. I was asked by Christina, she's running for it, we get some video devices or cable. So I was asked last night by Christina to tell you how, what kind of measures we have in order to promote research between young researchers. I can tell you that we have five main measures introduced in the last couple of years. First of all, we have a very good system by email in order to inform them about the research grants, about all applications, national and international. Second, we managed together with Monica here to build up a virtual library, which is working very nice. When I first started as a vice director in 2012, and I went with Monica into the library upstairs, I found six PCs, 486, if some of you might remember this number, very, very old computers. only four of them were working at that time. So we changed everything. Now we have a full digitized library. We can have access from everywhere in the watch by a dedicated program, which is Proxy. So we tried to give documentation and information to our researchers in order to provide research. Third, we have the International Congress, which I set up 3 years ago, which is dedicated to young doctors, to students. And last year, in fact this year, 2016, we had almost 3,000 participants. So it's getting very, very popular between young doctors and between students. Fourth, we have a journal in which they can publish. It's a journal which is on PubMed. We do not have any backup, unfortunately. But we try to help them to publish their own work in this journal, which has quite an international visibility since it is on PubMed. And fifth, 3 years ago, we introduced some small grants of about 5,000 euros for young researchers in order to stimulate them to finish the research or to start small projects. So we have a couple of measures in order to increase research in our university. They worked because we managed to increase our publications, our number of publications from less than 600 4 years ago to almost 1,000 in the last couple of years. So this is Romania. You have different pictures from Romania here. And thank you very much for being here. And I wish you a very, very successful